Welcome to the session. Right now it's going to deal with based on embedded systems. Here I'm going to explain you what an embedded system is and the specification and the categories of embedded systems and the definition of embedded systems. So here a definition which is specified based on embedded system is the system which is used to perform a specific task at specific intervals of time is nothing but an embedded system. The system which is embedded to perform a particular task using both hardware as well as software is nothing but an embedded system. So actually the embedded systems undergoes under three categories: a standalone embedded systems, real-time embedded systems, and network communication embedded systems. A standalone embedded systems comes under a category, just you can say an example of PC. So if you take a system called as PC, it is works only under a standalone mode. So it takes the input, converts according to the program and the task and everything, and gives an output only under standby mode. These kind of systems which perform a particular task only under a standby mode is nothing but a standalone embedded systems. A pure like embedded like examples come under standalone is nothing but your microwave oven, like refrigerating control systems, washing machines. This all work under only under standby mode. So you can't make the system to move here and there. So this is like standalone embedded systems. And coming to real-time embedded systems, these kind of embedded systems comes under a category based on specifically with the time period intervals. So here there are two types in this: hard real-time embedded systems and soft real-time embedded systems. A hard real-time embedded systems comes under a category with a kind of time period. So initially the system, you have to specify the performance of the system, it should be under a time period only. So if at all the input or the output that you are going to control crosses beyond the time limit, then it can be at any kind of damage. So you can see like boiler set point, temperature limit, or any kind of particular task, like say any kind of things that particularly based only on the time period intervals. So embedded systems come under this kind of category, like hard real-time embedded systems. And coming to soft real-time embedded systems, is like here the time period will be like specified, but if the performance of the task is not within the time period, then there is no damage for the product. Example like your TV remote. So if from the TV remote, if ever you give this input signals, so like the output whenever it receives, so here if it is a delay of time period, there is no like giving the information. If it is any particular delay, there is no damage either to the TV or to the remote. So these kind of based on time interval durations, if it is low or less, does not depend on the product. So this is like soft real-time embedded systems. So coming to network communication embedded systems. So these kind of communications most probably have more advantage, like in coming of upcoming technologies. Like coming to network communications, like your mobile networks, like coming to even like in mobile, best example, like you can see like major productions like mobile based, like touchscreen oriented, Android based, and using later, like initially using a keypad technique. So here came the DTMF technology and all these things. And coming to network, even to the PC, nothing but your GPRS, GSM, and even GPS technologies, all these come under a category of network communication. Here the embedded systems plays a very vital role for communicating from one network to the under multiple units. Either it can be from one to one or one to many. So these kind of communication networks like your bridges, routers, all these come under a category of network communication embedded systems. So this is like entirely an embedded systems category and the definition of it. And here even the applications also, it depends on like many applications are there, like your home applications, office appliances, industrial appliances, like your home automations, industrial automations, controllings, like event alertings, all these come under like the examples of your embedded systems. Thank you.